Fuyani Johnny moved to Cape Town just over 10 years ago with 200 rand in his pocket, with dreams of working at Soccer La Duma. Today, he's the editor. We're sitting down with him in his offices.
I grew up playing football, firstly, and then I was also interested in reading about the South African footballers and all that. So when I went to varsity, one of the things that I needed to do to complete my national diploma in journalism was to do inside training. So with Soccer La Duma, I knew it was that was exactly where I wanted to go, and then I applied for inside training. But before applying for inside training, I used to contribute a lot of letters to the editor, reacting on what was happening and all that. Growing up, one of my dreams was to play professional football. So when I realized that that dream is not going to materialize, the next big thing for me was to be part of football in any capacity. But because of my studies, I realized Soccer La Duma is a place to be. So that's how I got to Soccer La Duma. And I can safely say I'm living my dream, because the closest thing to playing professional football for me now is writing about professional football. It feels like it was only yesterday when I started out, because I came here in 2005. I came in 2005 to do in-service training, and then from there on I never looked back. I had not been outside of Eastern Cape at all. So when I made contact with Soccer La Duma, they invited me over for an interview. And then my parents were happy until they found out that the head offices were in Cape Town. And then that kind of changed everything, because at the time, there was a lot of gang violence going on in Cape Town, and that was mostly what they saw whenever they watched the news. So they were a bit skeptical about me coming to Cape Town. But my two friends, they were like, you know what? We respect your parents, but if you stay here for longer, you're going to become one of the statistics in this township, because we see a lot of people, young people, destroying their lives because of lack of job opportunities and all that. So we would hate to see you go down that route as well. So we're going to put some money together. We will send you to Cape Town. Go to that interview in Soccer La Duma. If things work out, perfect. If they don't, here's your return ticket fare. So they also gave me some pocket money. Now I had to go back to my parents and tell them, guys, my good friends have made me this offer. I need to go. Can you please just allow me to go and have this interview? And then we'll take it from there. I will be safe. Well, I'm enjoying my job here, and I don't even see it as a job, in fact, because it's more like a hobby for me, because I'm doing something that I'm so passionate about. So working for Soccer La Duma has opened my eyes in so many ways, personal growth and even growth in the industry. But I think the biggest challenge is trying to please everyone. I mean, we have a publication of mostly 24 pages. So to try and fit everything, make everyone happy, is the biggest challenge. But we always try, because at the end of the day, it's more about our readers, who are our boss, than us and what we feel they need. Your background does not have to dictate your destiny. So that's one of the things that I always told myself. You know, yes, I'm from poor background and rural area and all that, but that's not going to dictate who I am in the future. What happens with my future is my responsibility. I'm the only one who's accountable for it. I can't blame lack of opportunities and use that as an excuse to go off the rails and do bad things. So that's one thing that was always in the back of my mind. I also made sure to follow my passion, and I also made sure to grab the opportunities that come, and also take the risks to make sure that I get to where I wanted to be.